Usually people set up a company and give it a family name, like Ford by Henry Ford, Benz by Carl Benz, and McLaren by Bruce McLaren. None of them gave Henry or Carl a shot. And Bruce? That just sounds like a no-go for supercars. But that doesn't seem to bother today's car makers. He Xiaopeng bravely set the deal with his first name and built one of the best EVs in China. Guys, I'm Jack, this is where to go. The iconic Xpeng P7i. So it's been 4 years since the debut of this model, and they hasn't done much facelift, not mention any new ground up. But still, it looks slim and pretty. This is a medium version with less than 300 horsepower, but nearly 600 kilometers of range under WLTP standard. So pretty usable battery. And it shares a top speed of 200 kilometers per hour with its performance version, which gives out nearly 500 horsepower. So yeah, from this point, this car is not a bad deal. And business-wise, this is another head-to-head rival with Tesla Model 3. You might not notice, but this car actually has a wheelbase that's longer than that on the BMW 5 Series, Mercedes E-Class, or Audi A6. It's not compact at all, but a big piece of it just goes to the space between the front tire and the A-pillar. It really gives credits to the look, but after all, it doesn't have a longitudinal engine, so I say a bold move for them. And especially in this country where people could get really obsessed about cabin size. Well, luckily I'm not, and I kind of need to sit for a while, so let's just get in. Okay, so I'll give you a very quick look around the room. With those very good materials and contrast of colors, and all those leather cushioning and wrapping, and there's 20 speakers around the car, including those two trebles in the corners. And this is my fave, the desk. I don't see this quite often, hardly I think, but I just love how they made this little space such a nice accommodation for all the things you usually put on a table, like your laptops, your meals, whatever else. It literally took a big step towards making itself your cave, and they won't charge you for another 10 grand. So much respect to the car makers. Other than that, if we cool ourselves down and look around, we see this layout in a pretty conventional manner. Two displays in the front, very coherent straight lining with metal trim, and the central aisle with two layers, wireless charges on the top and the USB port on the bottom. But actually, it's practical, but a little bit boring. Or I am just asking too much. Doesn't matter. Let's just agree to disagree. One big difference lies in the screen, where they put the dock on the driver's side, which is more usable and better to look at. And it really eases my mind. For the co-pilots, sure, it's more difficult to maneuver or operate, but the voice control was always online, and actually I am more apt to use the voice control to get into all those functions. Oh, and one little thing I really like is this. It comes back up. So this is a back seat. For your information, this is a C-segment car. Although it doesn't look like one, it looks like a compact car. But as I said before, a big piece of the wheelbase just goes to the front engine. So it's understandable that I'm in this position. Well, there is some comfort, like the cushion is really good, it's comfort. And the back seat just leans back on a certain angle, so I will not sit pretty uptight. But this car is said to be so much more than just those gimmicks and what we see here. Volkswagen just spent $700 million on the collaboration with this car maker to get access to their intelligent driving technology and a seat on the board. This is big because I'm about to have a taste of it. It's been 4 years since its birth, where so many changes have taken place. The initial P7 caught our eyes with its splendid wing doors. Designs and gadgets were just nice and fascinating. Now, fading as the glow seems, it still comes out as a very nice car with so much to offer. I'm really expecting more from their collaboration with VW and their future moves, and hopefully you guys could give it a go yourself sometime. I'm Jack, this is Where to Go. We'll see you soon.